batulugunizibwa ini
okusoka yaddala nzo omukwa batakiriza engeri gye bakutemu honorable zake bakoze bubi babadde bamaze okumukwata ngali mukomera bwe babanga waliwe yamutugunyiza era nga betulayo ne muddwaliro si kirungi. No, I'm telling you now. I'm telling you now. It is totally unacceptable. That's point number one. Number two, there are many other opposition members who were caught distributing food. They have done nothing to them. Members of opposition. So, if you say people are annoyed with NRM, people within NRM are annoyed with NRM, there are people who are also annoyed with the opposition. Their members are annoyed with them. Because I've had several videos talking about opposition members who did not do things correctly. So members of parties are free to get annoyed with their parties. But the one of Honorable Zake is totally not acceptable to me and to many, many people in this country. And therefore, people who did it should be brought to book. But when you arrest somebody because of distribution of food, you've taken him in prison. You've given him the others who were caught and they were released. They should have released him or they should have put him in jail, but not to mistreat him.
Actually, people are asking that why is Zake, that whoever is caught in that is punished like that one.
People no, not all of them.
Hoping that no, there no, is no, no, others.
No, there were others. No, there were others who were caught and they were released. Zake has had a problem with the police, and I don't know what it is.
That's why we're asking.
But I think it was not handled. It was handled shabbily. It was handled badly. Because don't be told lies. The President Museveni here in Kampala, there were other opposition members who were stopped from provide for distribution food. And I will give you an example. In Kawempe North, in Nakawa here, they were stopped. But they were not mistreated.
And lastly,
and by the way, these are opposition members. So I wanted to make this very clear.
Just on that same issue. Our worry is, can we say that at one moment, the commander-in-chief, maybe the police, is doing something contrary to the commander-in-chief and the command can't discipline some of those officials? Because it's not the first time.
The security organizations all over the world sometimes uses excessive force. Police called police brutality. There is no country, starting with countries in the East, starting with the United States, starting with Britain, where we've heard of police brutality. Even in the war in Iran, even the war in Iraq, I've heard of security brutality, where they beat people very badly. Now, what we need to do is to be very, very clear, like we've been here saying, this was wrong. They should correct the situation. And His Excellency has made it very clear. He wants to know why the MP was mistreated. So I think what we need to do, and this is where I'm saying, let us not have conspiracy theories. Let's say this was unfortunate it happened, and this is not the first time it has happened. They should not allow this to go on. The young man might have a little bit of a problem, but it's something we can contain. You don't have to be that brutal.
So it doesn't have any something special with the government?
I don't think so. I think a few of these police fellows and security fellows, I think there are some security fellows involved, they should not use this brutality.